Hi, this is a video on a strange aberration which you can find sometimes with LEDs. This is an LED 8-watt Bonilux dimmable LED. It is unusual in the sense that it doesn't have any sort of circuitry, that, or at least that I can see, inside it, such as smoothing cap or resistor network, the various things that you often do see in LEDs. And you'll notice that even in the off position, it's lit. Dimly, but still lit. Now I'll switch it on just so you can see what it's like when it's switched on. The strobing that you see is because the light itself does actually strobe. And if we switch it back, you can see that again it's dimly lit. Now, if I show you against another 8-watt LED, which is the mini sun, this is a non-dimmable, you can see in the off position, it's not lit at all. In the on position, it's an 8-watt LED. There's no strobing at all in this. I quite like these and I recommend them. But anyway, the reason why I wanted to show this is because of this particular aberration, which is caused by the configuration of the lighting. Now, let me put this back into the off and we'll just take a look at the ceiling rose itself. Now, this is the ceiling rose, and this is a typical British ceiling rose, what it looks like, but it's been wired strangely, and the reason for that is because this is normally configured for switched live. So the live is switched, and the bulb is permanently connected to the neutral side of things. That's the normal configuration that you expect in the UK. Now, what I've done is I've changed that setup because I wanted to have a switch neutral. Sometimes you get this strange effect. And essentially what it's like is if you have an electrician screwdriver, such as this, and I was to put that onto the live, you can see that LED, well, it's not an LED, it's a neon, and it's lighting when I touch the back of it. And that's because the live wire is capacitively coupling through the electrician screwdriver, and it's essentially radiating energy from me, from my body, and that's why it's lit. Now, in this particular case, you can see that the live wire here, which is on the brown, is connected to the pendant itself. What we have here is the live wire is actually going into the pendant, so it's permanently connected to one side of the LED, and the other side is going through this red wire here, which is one side of the switch. It's coming back through the black wire, which is the other side of the switch, and it's looped in this particular orange wire into the neutral. So effectively what's happening is it's switching the neutral, so that the neutral is going to the switch and it's being switched at that point. So essentially we have the live connected to this, but in the off position the energy essentially would mean that the whole neutral side, this blue wire, up until the point where it reaches the break in the switch itself, will go live. And that, a bit like the electrician screwdriver, is like me touching the end of it, and it's radiating within the actual switch conduit network itself, and that is allowing just enough energy to actually light a bulb. Now, if I had an ordinary light bulb in there, because the tungsten requires so much more energy to show any sort of lighting, basically you'd see nothing. And in this particular case, where you have a network here, which builds a bit of a barrier for the electricity as such, which is allowing it to glow, and also there's a capacitor in there, which I believe is acting like a shunt, like a bypass. So it's never getting to the point where it has enough voltage to actually light it, even dimly. I'll take that out. Now, what I want to show is when I change this, so it's then going to switched live, that you will see a difference. So let me just put this on pause, and we're back. So now I've changed it, so it's going from the neutral line is connected to one side of the bulb. The other side is going to the black wire, which is one side of the switch. The other side of the switch, which is coming back, is the red wire, And let me just a little bit more of a close-up of that so you can see how it's changed. So the brown wire goes from this, goes into the black wire, which is the switch, comes back to the blue, which is the permanent connection to the mains neutral. The other side is the red wire, which goes through this orange loop into the mains, which is the brown wire here on that side there. So essentially this is what's called a switched live. And in this particular case, which I had earlier, which was glowing, and as you can see, in the off position, it is no longer glowing. So you can see the bulb is no longer glowing. So that's switched on. As you can see, it's strobing like it was before. And switched off, nothing. Whilst before it was glowing. And this is the mini sun. Again, if I switch that on, you can see that it's acting normally. They're both acting exactly the same way. And the way I would expect it to act. So hopefully this shows the aberration and explains the aberration. Thank you very much for watching, and till next time.